Hey guys, it's Kiran here, back to another video, and today we are diving deep into the Android 16 QPR Beta 1 update. More specifically, the one with the new visual overhaul brought by the Material 3 Expressive Design Language. This is one of the most striking updates Android has received in quite some time. It doesn't just look different, it actually feels different to use. Now, we've already seen a few glimpses of this through some early leaks by Michel Roman. Shout out to him for always being ahead of the curve. And Android officially showed it to us in the Android show, and I've been dying to get my hands on this ever since. And well, it's finally here. I have it on my Pixel 8 and I have a lot of thoughts. But before we dive into all the new features, let me quickly show you how to try it out for yourself. So if you have got a Pixel 6 or above, you can already get your hands on it. Now do keep in mind, this is still beta 1, so yeah, early software. I haven't run into any major bugs yet, but your mileage may vary. Just back up your data before jumping in. To get it, head over to android.com/beta, sign in with the same Google account you use in your Pixel, enroll your device, then go into Settings, System, System Update, and it should show up within a few minutes. Super easy. Alright, with that out of the way, let's actually talk about what's new. The star of the show here is the Material 3 Expressive Design Language. And it isn't just a new skin on top of Android, it is a full redesign centered around motion, fluidity, and responsiveness. The first thing you'll notice, animations. They are smoother, more dynamic, and they actually respond to your input. For example, when you swipe away a notification, it doesn't just vanish, it springs away with a subtle bounce. And if you let go halfway through, it snaps right back into place. Even cooler, notifications stacked at the top or the bottom can also now react with the movement too. When you interact with one, the others shift and respond with soft, coordinated motion. It's a small detail, but it gives the whole system this organic, lifelike feel. This kind of physics-based interaction is now everywhere, whether you're flipping through recent apps, toggling settings, or even just navigating menus. It gives Android a sense of weight and motion that feels modern and intentional. All these motion tweaks really show how much effort Google is putting into how Android feels. But visuals play just as big of a role in this update. And that brings us to another major piece of the Material 3 Expressive, how Android handles depth and layering across its UI. You'll start seeing blur effects used more consistently throughout the UI. Pull down the notification shade and you'll notice the background softly blurs, kind of like looking through frosted glass. It adds a sense of layering and depth that really elevates the whole look. When you turn on the battery saver mode, these blur effects are now replaced by a solid accent color instead. This is not just a visual change, it's done to cut down on GPU usage and help save power. A small touch, but a smart one. And speaking of smart touches that elevate the experience, let's talk about the Revamp Quick Settings panel, where visual flair meets practical interaction. The Quick Settings panel has been totally redesigned, and it's a big step up. When you pull it down, the motion feels more deliberate and more intentional. The toggles themselves are now larger and more spaced out and way easier to tap. Everything has these soft, rounded corners, and when you tap a toggle, there's this cute little bounce animation that syncs up perfectly with the haptics. It feels more fun and more satisfying to use. While adding new tiles, they are now categorized, making it easier to find exactly what you're looking for. You can now even resize the toggles and leave empty spaces, which make customizing your layout feel more flexible. And here's a smart touch. When you shrink the toggle down so the label disappears, it now shows the name instead of the active app spell. There is even a subtle shape change when toggles are switched on. They go from being fully rounded to a slightly boxier look, giving you a quick visual cue that something's active. And I love the attention to detail here. The Bluetooth pill, for example. Tap the pill and it opens up all your available devices. But just tap the icon and it toggles Bluetooth on and off. Super handy. You'll also feel haptic feedback while adjusting the brightness through the new slider. A small vibration with increasing intensity based on the level of brightness that gives the action a bit more physical presence. The slider itself has a more boxy design now, moving away from the fully rounded style. There's a clean line running through the track that clearly shows the current brightness level, making it easier to see and control at a glance. It's subtle, but it really adds a tactile sense of control. The volume panel has also received that same thoughtful treatment with the new slider with the same haptics too. And the same goes for the expanded volume panel too. It has gotten a nice little upgrade. It is now visually cleaner with a design that matches the new brightness slider. Same smooth motion, same layout, and yep, the same satisfying haptic feedback as you slide it. And here's a fun detail, when you're playing music, the volume panel now shows animated soundbars that move in sync with your audio. A really nice touch. And now, while we're on the topic of polish and little UX details, let's talk about the lock screen. Because this is another area where Android 16 is really showing off how refined and responsive it's become. and you tap to wake the screen, the animation now starts exactly where your finger touches. It's one of those tiny things that makes Android feel super responsive. There's also a new layout for date and temperature. If you have notifications, they appear to the right of the clock. If you don't, they move to the bottom of the clock, giving you a nice balanced layout either way. By default, lock screen notifications are now collapsed, even when your phone's unlocked, kind of like what Samsung's One UI does for extra privacy. But if you prefer seeing everything up front, you can turn that off in the new lock screen setting menu. It's actually got a few extra options now too, like the ability to hide notifications you've already seen. Super handy if you want to keep things tidy. And speaking of keeping things clean and personal, let's talk about the new revamped wallpapers and style settings. The interface now offers a more intuitive layout, making it easier to preview and apply wallpapers with added effects seamlessly. And now let's talk a little bit more about those revamped wallpaper effects. This is one of those subtle but really fun additions that add depth to the whole Material 3 Expressive vibe. When customizing your lock screen or home screen, you will notice some new effect options. Shapes, local weather, and something called cinematic. You can access all of these by heading into settings, wallpaper and style, and jumping into the lock screen customization. When choosing a wallpaper, either one of Google's or something from your gallery, you will get the option to add these effects and see them previewed live. Starting with shapes, it's exactly what it sounds like. You get layered geometric or organic patterns that animate very subtly across your wallpaper. It adds a nice sense of motion and personality without being too distracting. These shapes pick up tones from your wallpaper, so it still blends in perfectly with the Material U color palette. Next up is the local weather. This one's really neat if you're into real-time visuals. Based on your location, your wallpaper will now reflect actual weather conditions. So if it's raining, you'll see gentle raindrops falling on your screen. If it is sunny, there's a soft glow. It's really subtle, but it makes the phone feel more alive and context-aware. You can tweak the intensity of each effect too. You can go full dramatic or keep it chill, totally up to you. And finally, the cinematic effect. You'll need to download this effect first, but once that's done, it adds depth and motion using parallax. When you tilt your phone, different layers of the wallpaper move at slightly different speeds, creating a kind of 3D effect. With the wallpaper setting the tone, the home screen now completes the picture. It's been refined for both function and form. The default grid is now 5x6, so you can fit more apps, especially with a smaller at-the-glance widget. The app drawer has a new look. It now glides in as a floating sheet with smooth transitions and a soft blur behind it. And finally, there's a new system font. It's been quietly refreshed, so subtle in fact that you might not catch it at first glance. It took me a moment to notice it myself, but once you do, it clicks right into place. Moving past the home screen, the interface refinements continue. In the recent apps view, app cards are now bigger and include the app icon right in the preview. Swiping them away gives you the same soft bounce animation we saw with notifications. You can see the other windows reacting to my swipe too. Status bar icons have also been updated. The battery icon is now horizontal with the percentage inside it. It also changes color, green when charging, yellow for battery saver mode, and red when you are below 20%. Super helpful at a glance. The music pay in the notification shade still shows those animated squiggly lines we saw in earlier builds. On the lock screen though, that's just a static line for now. Maybe a bug, maybe intentional, let's see. So we've seen how the interface is evolving on the surface, but now let's head a little bit deeper. The settings app has also received a fresh coat of paint. It is now more colorful with more improved spacing and a layout that feels noticeably easier to navigate. Each section that contains additional options now displays a small arrow, clearly indicating that it can be expanded, making the interface more intuitive at a glance. Buttons throughout the app have also been enlarged. One notable return is the LE audio sharing. If you and a friend have both compatible earbuds, you can now stream the same audio simultaneously. Perfect for watching a movie or listening to music together without needing to share a single pair. Other refinements come in quietly, but they add to the polish. The check for update screen and the Google Pay system update screens have also been refreshed with a slightly bolder look. You will now notice a wider, more prominent button that spans across the bottom of the display. And on the Google Play update screen, a playful touch. Those familiar animated squiggles return, just a small detail. The app info page has also been cleaned up with three distinct buttons: archive, uninstall, and force stop. The spacing is also improved, making the battery and permission details easier to read. And for those using fingerprint unlock, managing them is now simpler. A new check and rolled fingerprint option lets you know which finger belongs to which print. And that's the rundown on the Android 16 QPR Beta 1 and the new Material 3 Expressive design language. And I gotta say, it is really exciting to see Android becoming more cohesive, more polished, and more fun to use. The Material 3 Expressive design language is all about motion, personality, and responsiveness. It makes Android feel less like just a bunch of features thrown together, and more like a fully cohesive experience. And now I want to hear from you. Do you enjoy this playful, animated direction Android is heading towards, or do you prefer a simpler, more minimal interface? What is your favorite part of the update? Let me know down in the comments below, I'd love to hear your take. And as always, if you found this video helpful, don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel and share it with someone who hasn't seen the Material 3 Expressive yet. And as always, thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next one.